हेलो स्टूडेंट, नाउ टुडे वी स्टार्ट विद द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 4, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी कंप्लीटेड 6 टॉपिक्स. आउट ऑफ दैट 6, द फर्स्ट वन इज योर डिजिटल मल्टीमीटर, दैट इज DMM. देन वील कवर अ फंक्शन जनरेटर, देन DSO, डिजिटल स्टोरेज ऑसिलोस्कोप. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी अगेन डील विद द नेक्स्ट 3 टॉपिक्स, दैट इज पावर स्कोप. Then we deal with the next, that is a power supply and auto transformer. Out of these 6 topics, maybe the question explain the block diagram and working principle of any of the that particular instrument. Now today we start with a permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer. Now actually the topic is analog DC voltmeter and analog DC ammeter. But before going to start the voltmeter and ammeter, we have to deal with the permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer, because the basic arrangement of voltmeter and ammeter is deal with the help of this galvanometer by making some resistance arrangement, whether it's in series or in parallel with the galvanometer, it form a voltmeter and ammeter. So before going to start DC voltmeter and ammeter, we started with what is the basic principle of the galvanometer, permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer. So as shown in the diagram, the PMMC galvanometer, or you can say the PMMC instrument, have following parts. First one is permanent magnetic set. Soft iron cylinder for damping of movement, that is for the damping movement of the pointer. Then moving coil, a pointer, scale, mirror and counter weight, or you can say the balancing weight. So all these are shown in the given PPTs. So how actually a permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer work? The current which is to be measured is passed through the moving coil as shown in the figure. And this moving coil produces, the current flowing through this moving coil is produces the electromagnetic field. Now the electromagnetic field and this permanent magnet also produce the magnetic field. So these both fields are getting interact with each other and produces the torque. The torque which is developed on a pointer, it is proportional to that current which is flowing through the moving coil. So due to this, the pointer displaces, but its movement is damp using the soft iron cylinder as shown, which is over the pointer. This is your pointer, and whatever may be the soft iron cylinder, it will be producing the damp movement. Okay, so whatever may be the position of the pointer, it indicates the value of the current printed on the scale. And this conversion of galvanometer may be used for a DC voltmeter as well as DC ammeter. So in the given figure, this is your scale, this is the mirror, this is a pointer, this N and S are the permanent magnetic set. Then this coil is known as a moving coil. Then whatever may be the field shown, these are the magnetic fields. Now whatever may be this, it is a balancing weight. And what is the principle of this PMMC galvanometer? Whatever may be the current flowing through this moving coil, and whatever may be the magnetic field is produced, and the field produced due to this permanent magnet, these are interact with each other and torque is produced. Once the torque is produced, the deflection of this pointer is getting take place, and magnitude of this deflection is depends upon how much quantity of current is flowing through this moving coil. And this is the simple whatever may be say the principle of the permanent magnet moving coil galvanometer. And the same this galvanometer is used to make a DC ammeter or DC voltmeter. Now we deal with the connection of the galvanometer, conversion of the galvanometer into DC ammeter. Now how to convert that galvanometer into the DC ammeter? This total arrangement is shown as a DC ammeter. Use the galvanometer and make one resistance parallel with your galvanometer. This combination gives you DC ammeter. So the galvanometer is used as an ammeter by connecting the low resistance wire in parallel with the galvanometer. So this is nothing but your DC ammeter. And whatever may be this capital G, that is galvanometer, its working is shown by in this diagram. So this is also a 3D diagram is shown how exactly the PMMC galvanometer is work. And here we have to explain one by one what about the DC ammeter. Now what is exactly the DC ammeter? Now this is the arrangement. This is your basic meter and this is the resistance which we have implemented in parallel with the, this is your meter and we have implemented the resistance in parallel with the galvanometer. So this is the basic diagram of your DC ammeter. It consists of shunt resistance, that is a parallel resistance. We can say the shunt resistance is denoted by RSH. Then the basic meter whose internal resistance is RM. It is also known as a coil, so it may be called as an internal resistance of the coil. The current flowing through this shunt resistance is given by ISH and current flowing through this basic meter is given by the IM. And the total current in the circuit, that is in a basic DC ammeter circuit, is I. So I equals to the summation of ISH plus IM. So this is about the your DC ammeter. The basic DC ammeter, it is also known as a D. Orsonval galvanometer, or in many books it is referred to as D. Orsonval movement. The coil winding of a basic movement is very small and light, hence it can carry very small current. So as mentioned earlier, for a large current, the major part of the current is required to be bypassed using a resistance, and this resistance is called the shunt. So and this is the arrangement of the basic ammeter. The shunt resistance can be calculated as follows. As we discussed, RM is the internal resistance, RSH is the shunt resistance. Now what about the next one? That is IM is a full scale deflection current, that current flowing through the basic meter. ISH is the shunt current, I is the total current. Now from this diagram you can say the voltage drop across this RSH and voltage drop across this RM, both the voltage drops are equal in magnitude because both are in a parallel combination. So voltage drop across RSH and voltage drop across RM are exactly equal. So by making these two voltage drop across them is same, ISH, according to the Ohm's law, the voltage drop is given by V equals to IR. So ISH into RSH is equals to IM into RM. So RSH is IM RM divided by ISH, but we know I equals to ISH plus IM, therefore ISH is equals to I minus IM. By making this total current equation, we have to put the value of ISH in the denominator of this equation and you will get IM RM upon I minus IM. So simply we introduce one factor which is known as a multiplying power. Okay, so that multiplying power is M. Now if we rearrange this term, RSH is equals to this, means in short you have to divide the numerator and denominator of this equation by IM, will get that I upon IM is replaced by the value M, and this M is known as a multiplying power of the shunt, and this multiplying power is given by small m and it is expressed as I upon IM. If you can rearrange this term, then you can easily get M equals to I upon IM equals to 1 plus RM upon RSH. So why we are deriving this multiplying power? Because maybe the chances are there that any numerical will be asked regarding to this DC ammeter. So you have to remember this formula, that multiplying power in DC ammeter for the shunt resistance is given by total current I divided by the IM, that is a full scale deflection current, or this formula is again given by 1 plus RM upon RSH. So now we'll discuss one simple numerical based on the DC ammeter. A numerical given, a 2 milliampere meter with an internal resistance of 100 ohm is to be converted to 0 to 150 milliampere ammeter. Okay, so calculate the value of shunt resistance required. Now this numerical is very simple. If we compare this numerical with this circuit diagram of the DC ammeter, a basic meter is given, Okay, means RM, this basic meter, the current flowing through this basic meter, these values are given and you have to find out that if the total current I is this much, find out the value of RSH. So if we deal with that numerical, the numerical is very simple. A 2 milliampere is the full scale deflection current. Whatever may be the 100 ohm, it is the internal resistance of that meter. So RM is 100 ohm and it is to be converted into 0 to 150 milliampere, means the total current I is 150 milliampere. Now we have the formula for RSH, IMRM upon I minus IM. Now few values are in ohm, so we have to convert this milliampere into ampere by converting it 2 into 10 raised to minus 3. And this 150 again converted into 150 into 10 raised to minus 3. By putting all these value, you will get the shunt value resistance in a ohm and this value is 1.351. ohm. So this is the simple numerical. Maybe the chances are there that you can ask regarding to the numerical also. Now the next one is the multi-range ammeter. Now this is the maybe the question that explain the DC ammeter with the multi-range ammeter. So you have to draw only this multi-range ammeter and one switch is shown. So instead of going for each time the simple single shunt resistance, we at a time introduce RSH1, means a series, your pattern of the shunt resistances, that is shunt resistance 1, 2, 3, 4. And whenever there is a requirement of RSH1, the switch is put at the RSH1. If your basic meter required the RSH2 shunt resistor, then put that switch to the second one, to the third one and to the fourth one. Means at a time you can be able to use this multi-range ammeter. So this is the multi-range ammeter and if there is a question, you have to deal with this multi-range ammeter. Now the next, that is the conversion of the galvanometer into the DC voltmeter. Now for making a galvanometer into the voltmeter, we have to introduce the high value resistance in series with the galvanometer. The galvanometer is used as a voltmeter by connecting the high resistance in series with the circuit. So it is exactly opposite to your ammeter. So when you are going with the ammeter, you have to put the resistance in a parallel while it's a low value resistance. And when you have to deal with the DC voltmeter, you have to put the resistance in series with that galvanometer. Now again, same, this is the basic DC voltmeter. So what about the DC voltmeter? Again, all the values are same, only instead of the shunt resistance, we are deal with the series resistance, which is denoted by the RS. We implement RSS in series with the RM. So RM is a basic meter. The full scale deflection current is the IM. Now as shown in figure, the basic, this is a basic DC voltmeter, which is nothing but a PMMC deorthogonal galvanometer. And the resistance is required to be connected in a series with the basic meter when it is used as a your voltmeter. Now the series resistance is called as a multiplier and the main function of the multiplier is to limit the current flowing through the meter which does not exceed the full scale deflection value. The voltmeter measures the voltage across the two points. This voltage is to be measured by means of this basic DC voltmeter. Now the voltmeter must be connected across the two point or a component to measure the potential difference with the proper polarity. Whether here we have plus and minus, so connect your voltage which is to be measured and then we are capable to measure this voltage with the help of this multiplier and with the help of this basic ammeter. So this is a basic DC voltmeter. Now as usual, our RM is internal resistance of the coil, that is the meter. RS is the series multiplier resistance. IM is the full scale deflection current and if V is the full range voltage which is to be measured, this is a V, full range voltage which we have to be measured. So when you have to measure this voltage, we have a current which is a IM with a summation of the RM plus RS. So this RM plus RS and whatever may be the current flowing through these both resistances. So V equals to Im in bracket Rm plus Rm. Multiply this Im to this Rm and Rs individually, we get Vm is equals to ImRm plus ImRs. So by making some rearrangement of this term, we take ImRs at the one side and V minus RmRm. So ultimately we have to find this multiplier resistance Rs. So we rearrange the term and you will get the multiplying factor of that resistance, that is Rs, is V upon Im minus Rm. Divide this whole equation by this Im, simply you will get the Rs. So the multiplying factor for a multiplier is the ratio of full range voltage, ratio of full range voltage to be measured, and the drop across the basic meter. This is the drop across the basic meter. So if we consider small v as a drop across the basic meter, means in this equation this ImRm is replaced by small v. So the multiplying factor small m in case of a DC voltmeter is capital V upon small v. So simply put the value of capital V, which is a we calculate here, capital V ImRm plus ImRs, put it here, Im in bracket Rm plus Rs, and so by rearranging the term, that is Im Rm plus Rs, ImRm, ImIm get cancelled, Rm by Rm is 1 plus Rs divided by Rm. Hence the multiplier resistance can also be expressed as Rs is equals to M minus 1 into Rm. So this is all about the DC voltmeter. Now as we learn about the DC ammeter numerical, we also take one numerical for DC voltmeter. But before that, again we'll revise the DC voltmeter. Very simple, as the diagram is given, that is we have to find out the value of this multiplier for that Rs. Okay, so we calculate the capital V, which is ImRm plus ImRs. In the next we rearrange the term and we calculate the value of Rs also. But if we can consider that drop across the basic meter, means this, the drop across this basic meter is denoted by small v, which is Im into Rm according to Ohm's law. So this equation is multiplying factor small m is given by capital V upon small v. So we have both the equations, rearrange the equation and you will get Rs is equals to M minus 1 into Rm. So if you have to calculate the value of Rs for the given numerical, then you have to utilize this formula. Now we'll take a numerical, a very simple numerical is there. A moving coil instrument gives a full scale deflection for a current of 20 milliampere, means the full scale deflection current is 20 milliampere with a potential difference of 200 millivolt across it, means the voltage drop across that voltmeter, that is Vm, is 200 millivolt. Calculate the first one, shunt required to be it as an ammeter. So first of all we have to convert it into the ammeter, so definitely will require the RSH. To get a range of 0 to 200 ampere, means the capital I for the that ill required is 200 ampere, and the second multiplier required to use it as a voltmeter of range 0 to 500 volt. So drop across the meter Vm is 200 millivolt. So Vm is equals to ImRm. So from that we have to calculate the Rm. So 200 millivolt is equals to 20 milliampere into Rm. So convert 200 millivolt into volt and 20 milliampere into the ampere, and then we'll get the Rm equals to 10 ohm. So first case we have to use it as an ammeter. So what is the for use it as an ammeter, the range is 0 to 200 ampere, means capital I is equals to 200 ampere. So shunt resistance is ImRm upon I minus Rm. So put all the values in units and you will get the shunt, means low value resistance. It is a 0.001. So from that numerical you can also clear the things that for the DC ammeter the resistance should be very low. So the it indicate the value, that 0.001, because we can introduce the resistance in parallel, but which kind of resistance? Low value resistance in parallel with the meter. So it's a 0.001 ohm. Now what is the second one? For that we are using the galvanometer as a voltmeter. Range is 500 volt. Calculate the RS, that is V upon Im minus Rm. We have the values of Im, we have the values of Rm, capital V. So capital V is given in your numerical. Okay, so what is the range? It is 0 to 500 volt. So it is your 24.99 kilo ohm. So this is the required multiplier of your DC voltmeter. Now again you can recognize that whatever may be the value of resistance, it is in kilo ohm and it is 24 kilo ohm. So in the same way, when you have to prepare the voltmeter, you have to introduce high value resistance in series with that. So this is regarding to the DC voltmeter. So this is a simple numerical on DC voltmeter. Again, one simple numerical is there for DC voltmeter. A moving coil instrument gives a full scale deflection with a current of 40 microampere, while the internal resistance of the meter is 500 ohm. It is to be used as a voltmeter to measure a voltage range of 0 to 10 volt. Calculate the multiplier resistance needed. So in short, we have to calculate RS, that is multiplier. The meter resistance is 500 ohm. Full scale current flowing through the meter is 40 microampere. That we have to be convert into ampere by multiplying it into 10^-6. Then V, which is to be 10 volt. So by simply putting V divided by Im minus Rm, all these value, you will get the value 249.5 kilo ohm. Again, the multiplier resistance is in the range of kilo ohm and the value is again high. So the when you can deal with the DC voltmeter, definitely the value of the multiplier is high. So this is all about the DC voltmeter and DC ammeter. Again, the same question is there, that is a multi-range voltmeter. Again, you have to introduce a number of resistances, that is multipliers, RS1, RS2, RS3, RS4. The load is given through which you have to measure the voltage. This is a plus minus, you have to measure this voltage and your meter is connected here. So this meter is connected to either V1 or V2 or V3 or V4, depending upon the requirement of this load or which kind of or how much quantity of voltage you have to measure, you have to be connect this to one by one. So this is all about the multi-range voltmeter. Now these are the some expected questions for the unit number 4. As we discussed earlier, the question number 1 is explain the digital multimeter with block diagram, that is your DMM, or explain the function generator with a block diagram, explain digital storage.